Kingdom Hearts 2 is the best game ever made. I said it and it needed to be said. Whatever game you think is the best game ever made, I hate to break it to you. Kingdom Hearts 2 already has that title, and no game for the rest of history will ever take it away from it. Alright, I just needed to get that off my chest. Kingdom Hearts 2, best game ever made, but even the best game ever has its flaws. Kingdom Hearts 2 improved on the formula set in stone by its big brother Kingdom Hearts 1 in many ways, but definitely the biggest thing it improved was the combat. KH1's combat feels pretty slow and clunky in comparison to KH2. For most of the game, you have a 3-hit combo that is pretty slow and not very accurate. Kingdom Hearts Final Mix improved on the combat just a tiny bit. What am I even saying? No, it didn't. It just added new abilities like Combo Master. With Combo Master equipped, you can perform combos without even attacking an enemy, which is pretty neat. You can use it to see what different abilities do. Or, honestly, I don't even know what else you'd use Combo Master for in Kingdom Hearts 1. I'm not gonna lie. And you know what makes no sense?
Nope.
Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix was released in 2002, a day after Christmas, and it had Combo Master in it. So why in 2005, in the original release of Kingdom Hearts 2, Combo Master was nowhere to be found? Legit makes no sense to me. Why would you add an ability like Combo Master in Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, then in 2005 release Kingdom Hearts 2 and not have that ability in the game? But then 2007 comes around and then you put the ability back in the re-release for Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. I just don't understand. Alright. I'm going on a tangent about Combo Master, an ability exclusive to the Final Mix releases, and it has nothing to do with this video. Where were we? Combat. Combat is one of the best things about the GGOAT, greatest game of all time. And it was a major improvement over the first game, which was mostly a 3-hit combo game. Honestly, KH1 hurt my thumb badly. I should have seen a doctor. One of the things that made combat incredible in Kingdom Hearts 2 was the coolest addition to any video game ever, drive forms. Honestly, I just want to say thank you to the fairies that gave Sora Valor Form. They just don't get enough credit. Drive Forms are basically Super Saiyan transformations. They give Sora more power. In Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, there are 5 forms in total. Valor, Wisdom, Master, Final, and Limit Form. Limit Form is exclusive to the Final Mix release of the game. In this form, Sora gets moves from his last adventure like Sonic Blade and Ars Arcanum. Drive Forms added even more diversity to the already amazing combat of Kingdom Hearts 2. And you can even level them up. Wait, you can level them up? After getting Valor Form and you've landed in Hollow Bastion, the game will tell you about Drive Forms. Oh no. No. The game tells you about Drive Forms the first time you open up the pause menu after getting Valor Form. Wonderful. The game tells you about form abilities, and it tells you that some form abilities can be used when you're not in that form by leveling up the Drive Form. Then the game never brings up anything about leveling up Drive Forms again.
We're back.
Means nothing. You're home.
I thought I was gonna mention leveling up Drive Forms again, man. Now, this brings me to... Honestly, this kinda hurts me to say this. The worst thing in the GGOAT. Leveling up Drive Forms. Drive Forms are one of the coolest things in this game, there is no doubt about that. But to get the full benefits out of them, you gotta level them up. And let me tell you, that is not fun. That's coming from a guy with over probably 100 plus hours on this game from multiple save files. Like I said before, there are 5 Drive Forms in this game, and each one of them can be leveled up, granting you abilities that can be used without being in the forms, like Quick Dodge, High Jump, Aerial Dodge, Glide, and Dodge Roll. While playing KH2 for the first time after beating Kingdom Hearts 1 and Rechain of Memories, I was like, where the heck is the Dodge Roll? I literally went on Google and looked up how to get the Dodge Roll in Kingdom Hearts 2. Get this, Dodge Roll was not even in base Kingdom Hearts 2. How can you have such an an iconic move like Dodge Roll and not even put it in the sequel. You know what replaced Dodge Roll? Quick Run. And that's the problem. Abilities that you got in Kingdom Hearts 1 like High Jump, Dodge Roll, and Glide were locked behind level up walls, and the game does a horrible job of pointing out to you that you need to level up your dry forms to get them. Now, the game does tell you that if you level up your dry forms, you can unlock abilities, but that is at the beginning of the game, and the game doesn't even tell you how to level up the forms. Like, dude, how are you gonna be the GGOAT and not tell people how to level up dry forms, dude? Well, the game actually does tell you how to level up each individual form. But in order to find this out, you have to open up the menu, go down to status, hover over a dry form, press confirm, then hover over experience, and then, only then will it tell you how to level up the specific form. Why? Why do I have to go all the way down to status to figure out how to level up a form? Why does the game not even tell me to go here to see how to level up a form? Nomura, you could do better, dude. So now we know where to go to find out how to level up a form. But every form has a different way of leveling it up. Some better than others. Let's list them now. Valor form gains 1 experience point for every attack dealt to an enemy. This one is not too bad. Who am I kidding? This one sucks. In the final mech version of the game, this one is pretty easy to level up when the Mushroom 13 is unlocked in Agrabah. You just hit it a bunch of times, but still, your thumb will be killing you after that. Wisdom form gains 1 point of experience for each Heartless defeated. 1 singular point. This is honestly one of the worst ones to level up because you get 1 XP for killing a singular Heartless. The amount of Heartless you need to kill in Wisdom form to reach the form's max level is 500. Yeah, more like 500 hours of my life wasted. Master form gains 1 experience for every small Drive Orb obtained, and gains 3 experience for every big Drive Orb obtained. This one is not too bad in Final Mix because of the Cavern of Remembrance, but it still sucks. You have to go back and forth and back and forth to get these damn Drive Orbs. I could not even imagine how painstakingly exhausting it would be to level up this form in base Kingdom Hearts 2. What am I saying? There's this trick in Twilight Town. There's these dealer nobodies, and you can use this ability called Drive Converter. They drop money, but this ability turns money into Drive Orbs, so that's a super easy way to level up Master Form. Wait, does Drive Converter even exist in base Kingdom Hearts 2? No, it doesn't. Beautiful. Final form gains experience by defeating nobodies. Each nobody defeated, including bosses, I never knew that, gives Sora 1 experience point towards final form. Leveling up final form is basically the same as leveling up wisdom form. 1 singular XP point for killing 1 nobody. The World That Never Was has a grinding spot for this that can also level you up at the same time. But still, you will have needed to kill 450 nobodies while in final form to reach max level and get Glide to level 3. Why do you have to grind it so much, man? And lastly, Limit Form. Limit Form gains 1 experience point for every successful use of Sora's Limit, specifically the final attack of the Limit. Alright, honestly, leveling up this one is not that bad because the times you need to use a Limit is not a lot at all. To get the max level, you need to successfully finish a Limit 90 times, so not that bad. Plus, you can use the Mushroom 13 in Agrabah like you would do for Valor Form, but you're gonna need a lot of ethers. So, leveling up forms like Valor and Limit Form are not that bad on their own, but couple in the fact that you need to level up each form in the game to get their level 3 growth abilities for Sora, leveling them up becomes more of a chore than a breeze. Now, I'm not gonna lie, in base KH2, what is really the point of unlocking the growth abilities? There really isn't. The only thing they'd be useful for is for getting around maps faster or dodging enemy attacks. But with the release of Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, they were given a purpose. Cavern of Remembrance has some of the best background music ever. It's just so chill, but that's not what makes it good. The Cavern of Remembrance gave the growth abilities a reason to exist. To get further into the Cavern of Remembrance, you need to have your drive forms leveled up to basically the max, except High Jump. What's the point? But you need your Quick Run leveled up to get here, you need your Aerial Dodge to get here, and it's also needed to get to this shortcut. You also need your Glide level up to the max to get here. Getting through the Cavern of Remembrance gets you here, the Garden of Assemblage. And just to get here, you need to painstakingly grind 5 drive forms all the way to max. Honestly, you don't need Dodge Rule. But still, that's like 2 to 3 hours of your life that you can never get back. But then, you sit back in your chair and you think to yourself, was it worth it? Grinding all these forms? Yes, it was, because now you get to experience 13 super bosses. Despite being the GGOAT, Kingdom Hearts 2 has one glaring flaw: leveling up the drive forms. While everything else in this game flows so gracefully, having to level up one of the best things ever introduced in the history of gaming is one of the worst experiences ever in gaming. Or maybe I just hate level grinding. Which I do. What are your thoughts on leveling up drive forms? Let me know in the comments. Anyways, hope you had a great day. See ya!